Okay. I have two last questions. I know you guys.
No and yes.
Do you guys still keep in contact with Glenn or?
Oh, look, Glenn was like a big brother to me in the music scene. I was 17 when I started in the band. Mm-hmm. And Glenn was, he's about 4 years older than me. And Glenn was more avant-garde, I guess you could say, than right. all the kids who were in school at his time. And we went to Lodi High School, both of us. And Glenn was out of school before I got in. You know, in school, I was a jock. I'm sorry to disappoint most of you people, but you know, I played football and stuff like that. And I was going to go to the NFL, you know. So that was my thought. And what happened was that I heard "Search and Destroy" by Iggy Pop, and all of a sudden, you know, getting hit on the football field wasn't half as aggressive as that. And I just said, well, you know, if I'm going to take it to the hoop, I'm going to do this. So I always worked with Glenn. Me and Glenn were friends right to the last day of the band. And what happened was I said, look, if, you know, we needed to play with a drummer to go to Germany. Okay. We had the drummer quit. Robo quit. You guys know Robo. Robo mm-hmm. quit. And we didn't have a drummer to go to Germany to release the Earth A.D. album, which was being released in Germany, which was kind of cool having a European release before an American release back in the day. And Glenn wouldn't play with Googie, who played on the Walk Among Us album. And I said, look, Googie's the only one who'll be able to get this together in 3 weeks. There's too much material, you know. Googie knows all but this new record. I could teach him the new record in 2 weeks. And I ain't playing with Googie. And I said to myself, look, if Glenn will blow off the release of an album rather than play with this guy for 20 shows, okay, then there's a problem. There's no sense in taking it 10 steps up and having it fall down on me. Mm. You know what I mean? I had a machine shop. I had a business. I had a family. It was just like I said to myself, if you're going to piss away this opportunity because you can't work with somebody, then this ain't ever going to work. Where am I going? And we broke up that day, and we didn't speak until we were in court. And then after that, we did depositions and stuff, and we figured we were coming to terms. I wanted the band. He wanted the publishing. I didn't care about the publishing. I wanted to make new music. I didn't want to get a check in the mailbox from Metallica. I didn't care about that. Okay. I cared about coming here and playing for you guys and doing this radio show more than I cared about that.
Oh, yeah.
So what happened was that, we came back. I think we've done an amazing job. I think our newer stuff is better than our older stuff. Okay, there's people who won't agree, but I'm happy you don't agree, because if everybody agreed, I'm doing something wrong.
Right.
Okay, some of you people have to hate me, and I know that, and I want that, you know, so that's okay. So the thing was with Glenn, I am at a point now where I'm shooting for 50 years. I got another 14 years. I want to keep this thing going, mm-hmm. you know, and I'm in a position now where I know Glenn's, you know, kind of cutting back. I consider doing something with him. You know what I mean? But not at the risk of, see the kids over there coloring your posters, not at the risk of them being driven down the wrong road to do it, okay? Because Glenn's had some of that black stuff and the, you know, the devil shit.
Yeah.
You know, I'm a Jesus guy. I don't deal with that crap, you know. I watch horror films, okay? And I lift weights. And, you know, try and stop us if you can. I mean, that's the name of the game, you know? So the thing is, if Glenn wants to be in the Misfits and leave the Danzig thought behind him, I'm in. Okay, but if not, then that's fine too, because we're doing swell, and awesome. You know, I'm happy, you know, fronting the band, and you know, look, we're good. You know, I wouldn't trade places with any other guy in any other band. You know, I think this band was worth fighting for all the years, and you know, I think that the kids that follow us really gain a lot of strength. They get a lot of kids come up after the show and we're signing stuff, saying, hey, you know, not for nothing, but you got me through hard times. I had, you know, I was abused as a kid, but your music, I listened to it, and I'm alive today. You know, I had thought of killing myself. I had thought of, you know, going out and doing crazy stuff, and you guys kept it together for me. And, you know, if you can reach one person like that, I think that it's not a waste of time. You know?